So thank you so much, Sonny Payne, for being on our third annual Delta Music Show.
Thank you.
So I've read that Robert Jr. Lockwood and Sonny Boy Williamson would play live there on King Biscuit Time. What was that like?
It was wonderful. They used to work at Interstate Grocery Company, and it was in November 18, 1941. And that's when I first got my job at the radio station. I went and told all the school kids, hey, I'm going to be on the radio. And when I got up, we were on the second floor, and I had to climb all those damn steps. And I got up there, and my boss, not this one, but my first boss, he stood there at the top of the steps, and he says, well, you did right. You came back after school, and you got your homework. I come on in here, and I said, what's that? And he said, this is a broom, this is a mop, and that's, I'll tell you where to go in a minute. And I said, what did I do with that? He said, haven't you ever heard of mopping floors and sweeping? I said, yes, sir. He said, that's where we start. And I said, when do I go on the air? He said, when I tell you to, it might be a year from now, it might be 6 weeks from now. It might be 10 years from now. But anyway, that's how we got started. Robert Jr. then found out about it. And they caught me on the street and they said, do you think Mr. Anderson would let us play on the radio? I said, you have to have a sponsor. He said, can you introduce us to him? So I did introduce him. And he and Sonny Boy came up and he said, it costs money to be on the radio. And the only way I can get you on is to get you a sponsor. I'm going to send you back to Max Moore where you work anyway, part time. And see if Max will sponsor. Here's where it comes in. Max Moore says, well, I really can't afford to do this, but he said, I'll tell you what, I got a flour that's been on the market. I got a half a box carload of it out there. I can't give the damn stuff away. It was called King Biscuit Flour, put out by Bueller Mills in Kansas. And he said, if you help me sell a half box carload, I'll keep sponsoring you. And he did. We had, back in those days, you know, ladies would go in the beauty shop. Hey, call a radio station and have Sonny Boy play me a song. But don't tell him who it is. My husband will kill me. No, really. Oh, that... See, back then, you didn't do those things. But nevertheless, to answer your question, I'm going a long way around. That's how we really got started with that stuff. And they sold it all out, and he kept them on. That's how King Biscuit got its name. And my boss, present boss, Jim Howe, and his wife are here with me tonight. And they bought the radio station in 1982. I don't know. You guys keep up with that. I don't. But, and that name belongs to KFFA Radio. You hear a lot of stories here and there and everywhere, but King Biscuit Flour has been on the market since 1930. I don't think they still make it. They make a flower, but we still carry the name and do our show. And it'd be my bedtime if I keep that up. What else? Do you got?
So I know you've met so many incredible musicians from all over the world. Do you have a favorite that you've met or that you're friends with?
No, I don't have any favorites, and I'll tell you why. You got good musicians, bad musicians, indifferent musicians, and they're all out there for one thing. They're trying their best to do what they know best. That's to play music. Now, some of them aren't going to be Frank Sinatra or anybody else, and some of them aren't going to be Les Paul on the guitar and all that. They're not going to be as good as someone else, but they are good at what they do, and they're playing their heart out trying to please people, and that's what they do best. I don't like to point out favorites. I don't have a favorite. They're all my favorites, all of them.
All right, we have just a few minutes here at the end for audience questions. So if you'd like to ask Mr. Payne, or actually Sonny, he insisted I call him Sonny. If you'd like to ask Sonny a question, raise your hand. The mic goes pretty far. I'll bring the mic to you. Wait till I get it to you to ask the question, so we'll capture it for the radio show. And you can ask a question and get your answer tonight.
You said you don't have a favorite, but Robert Junior Lockwood is your favorite.
He was as a person.
Right.
No, seriously, as a person. He was my favorite out of all the guys that I have met.
Sonny, would you tell us a little bit about when you traveled with Harry James? I remember when Betty Grable died and they called the station all day that day.
Honey, I used to be a bass player. I wasn't worth a damn then. I'm still not worth a damn.
Sonny, if I may call you that, will you come back and see us again and tell us some more of these wonderful stories?
You know how to make a grown man cry, don't you? Thank you.
Who do you think is the best young blues musician out there today?
I didn't hear that.
I say, who do you think is the best young blues musician out there today?
I still didn't catch it.
Young musician today, who do you think is the best?
Young musicians, well, you got so many. Are you referring to blues, jazz, big band, blues? Oh. It's just too numerous. We had a festival in Clarksdale three weeks ago. There were some kids that came on the show. I had no earthly idea who they were, from up in Seattle, Washington, or somewhere up in that area. And you don't ever hear any blues artists from up in that neighborhood. I never have. And they must have been 16, 17, 18. They're learning. You learn this business. And as I said before, you have to live it and learn it. But these kids, 16, 17, I don't know their names. I got it written down in their guest book at the station. I have no earthly idea. There's so many. You got some kids out there. I heard a bass band. I don't mean this one necessarily, but I heard a bass band several weeks ago. He was 20. And that was my instrument. He scared me to death. I said, I'll never touch my bass again. He did so many things with it that it frightened me. And I said, I'm grateful for the time that I had. And to answer your question, I don't know names. There's so many to come in the station. They'll come in there. I had a 16-year-old come in there one day and say, I got a little 4-piece band. Can you put me on? He said, I play the blues. I said, I play Muddy Waters. I play this one. What you have to learn, I don't want to hear Muddy Waters. I don't want to hear Sonny Boy. I want to hear how you sound. You got to do your own thing, not what somebody else does. Now, it's all right to play their songs and their music, but you do not, under any circumstances, play their stuff. You do your own thing. That's the only way you get anywhere in this business. I hope that answers your question.